gonna trust that colors on your Ogre 4K60, bro. You'll go from this. To this. Technician Aziz, take it away.
This is what it's looking like through the Elgato right now on OBS. So now switch to the Elgato software, you can immediately see how much better it looks already. The Elgato software allows HDR, since obviously the Elgato itself is a HDR device. However, OBS or other third-party softwares won't allow HDR and they'll convert it, I guess, to SDR, which is where the problem comes from. So to fix this, it's easy. All you gotta do is hold Control or Command on Mac and then click on Settings. If you then go into the Device tab, you'll see these two new inputs. You want to tick both of them. Then you just apply. Make sure you hold Command or Control whilst going into Settings, otherwise you won't see them there like how I've just done. It's almost as if Elgato is trying to hide this so you could use their software rather than OBS, but who knows. One more thing I like to do is play around with the picture quality, so I've changed the brightness to -5, the contrast to 20, and the saturation to 40. What this does is just gives it that extra nice little bright look. The thing is, you'll never be able to get it as good as it is on your monitor only because of the HDR tone mapping little problem with the OBS. They don't allow for HDR, so this is the best we can do right now. Also, make sure the settings I have here under the Device tab are also set on your software. Alright, so now what you gotta do is you wanna add the Elgato to the OBS software. I'm assuming most of you have done it, but in case you haven't, I'm gonna show you how to do it. You can see mine is already there, but I'm gonna do it again. So what you wanna do is you wanna go to that plus sign, you wanna head over to the video capture device, and then from here you can see mine's already there, the Elgato, but you wanna go to add a new source instead. Click that, and here you can change the name to whatever you want. Alright, so once you've got your name, what you gotta do, you just add source, and look, you can see it's already taken over my OBS because that's at the top of the sources now. Okay, so the next thing you wanna do is right click onto the Elgato, go into properties, and there you can see the settings that I've put down. Don't worry about the resolution or the FPS because that should be set on your Elgato software itself. All you wanna change is the color space, the color range to 709 and 4, that's pretty much it. Okay, so this is the last thing. All you gotta do is go to settings at the bottom left of your Streamlabs OBS, click onto that. Then you should go over to the Advanced tab, and then from here you just make sure that the video settings are as follows. And that's it! Look how much better this is compared to what it was before. Now if this helped you, all I ask for is just to leave a like. Obviously if you're feeling extra generous, subscribe is right there and it's free, please! I make weekly videos that you'll definitely laugh at. Watch a couple if you don't believe me!